Okay, we'll continue with it. So we have to learn this kalimirayaticum and then followed by one by combination. So homeopathic data, hearings guiding symptoms in volume 6, you'll get this remedy, the details about this remedy. But they are mixed with symptoms of kalichlor. See, this is the again one more study by Schussler that he explains over there. It has been mixed to kalichloricum with the kalimirayaticum, and that's why you never get clear-cut idea in hearing guiding symptom. So better to learn kalimur in a different manner. Tracurations and dilutions are used and for administration. Schussler's preference is for the 6x or 12x, though laterally he has given lower potency. In diphtheria, he recommends a gargle of the 3x, 10 or 15 grains in a tumbler of water. Its external application is recommended in burns, boils, carbuncles, skin affections, warts, etc. to be applied on lean dressing. See, this is because, why it is so? Because it oozes. That there is burns, there is always it is a vesicular or bullous eruptions are there. And that contains then that exudate, which is very typical of a kalimirayaticum. And that's why it plays very vital role in burns as a local application for the just a lint and kalimur. You can dissolved solution of kalimur you can add over there. So these are the different ways of application which he has mentioned over there. And now we'll turn towards the next slide. This is very important, relationship of this remedy. Corresponding as it does to the second stage of inflammation, inflammatory troubles, immediately upon appearance of exudation, its nearest concordants are bryonia, mercurius, apis, thuja, spongia, iodine, pulsatilla, rustox, and sulfur. So these are the very close relation, having close remedies related with this. Kalimirayaticum, you'll find bryonia, mercurius, apis, thuja. You'll have the typical discharge which is close to it. Pulsatilla, rustox is also having the cellulitis like that. So these are very important remedy. One must study in correlation with the kalimirayaticum. Analysis of the following drugs show them to contain kalimur in quite considerable quantities. Homeopathically considered. So kalimur is present in phytolacca. It is present in sanguinaria, it is in stillingia, it is Pinus canadensis, Asclepias, Elianthus, Anistillata, Hemamelis virginum, Cynicipiba, the Berberis vulgaris. All these remedies contains kalimirayaticum, and that's why there is a close relationship, or there are number of remedies which comes, or number of features of both remedies comes closer at this level. Most of these possesses many symptoms in common with kalimur. When full chemical analysis shall have been made of various drugs, vegetable and animal, we shall be able to compare the symptoms of each drug with those of its component parts. Comparing Eustachian tube troubles, Merck dulcis. Yes, already we have learned that kalimur is the best remedy in aurist's hands. That's what we have learned. Merck dulcis is one more remedy, where you will have a similar type of plastic exuded. For earache troubles with generally vertigo, think of a Merck dulcis. That is another important remedy. Along with a kalimur you can give. So you can give homeopathic Merck dulcis along with the kalimur in biochemic 6x doses. In syphilis, follow with the kalisulf and silicium. And nowadays, there are very less cases which you get of the syphilis directly because of a lot of antibiotics entered. In lupus, again, a tuberculosis of the skin, it is calcarea fos along with the kalimur, one must think of. So this is what regarding the remedy, kalimur. And one more slide is there for the kalimirayaticum, which one must understand. In Schussler therapeutics, kalimur assumes a role much like a sulfur in pure homeopathy as a deep acting remedy with eradicating tendencies. which useful as an intercurrent and to prepare the way for other indicated remedy. So we know that whenever any remedy is not acting, we use, it has been said that sulfur is the best remedy to give as an intercurrent so that the best selected remedy can act. In the Sisler's 12 tissue remedy, this is Kalimur is one more remedy which can be used like a sulfur on the same indication. Kalimur is frequently followed by a calcarea sulf, which latter completes the action of the former. So calcarea sulf always completes the action of Kalimur if the inflammation goes or reaches to the third stage. Kalimur follows Ferumfos. Yes, that is the, because Ferumfos is the first stage of inflammation. Kalimur is the second stage of inflammation. When the true lymph exudation of ripening interstitial inflammation sets in, and lymphatics madhe exudation hoon, that again is a fluid tire dhalela cell, and any wound or any ulcer or any eczema, if discharging like a plastic exudate, think of a Kalimur and it settles immediately. It also supersedes natrum mold when the deeper layers of epithelium adjoining the connective tissue basement are involved and even suffer exfoliation, causing white coated tongue and opaque whitish secretions. So cellulitis, this remedy plays very vital role. Cellulitis along with Kalimuraticum, Epis is one more remedy. Rustox is one more remedy. And this, when you learn this clinically, then you are able to differentiate those remedies. In Epis, you will get the typical edema and reddish pinkish hue along with the stinging pains. Immediately you can locate, yes, this is Epis mellifica. In Rustox, along with that, there is a specifically a restlessness. Patient is very sensitive to the pain with a typical cellulitis and tremendous itching in case of Rustox. So this clinical understanding, once develops in your mind, then the prescription becomes quite easy. So looking towards a cellulitis, you can differentiate. If it is specifically purple hue cellulitis on left lower extremity or left ankle, your remedy is lachesis. So that clinical presentation itself sometimes denotes you the remedy. But for that purpose, you should be very thorough with your clinics and your clinical knowledge. And you should be very thorough with your remedies while reading all those remedies. Then it becomes very simple to match the remedy at that level. Kalimuraticum may be compared with the chlorate, Kalichlor, the most poisonous of all the potash salts. The violent irritant of the whole gastrointestinal mucous membrane, producing gangrenous ulceration. Yes, Kalichloratum is a syphilitic remedy. Ulcerations throughout, from mouth to anus, throat ulcerations are there. Comparing aphthi, dysentery, and epithelioma and nephritis with Kalichlor, they are very close to each other, but Kalichlor is more syphilitic, most violent, and specifically have a very specific action right from the mouth to the anus with tremendous ulceration and sometimes with the cancerous changes also. So Kali salts plays very vital role in pathologies. Kali sinatum is there. Kali sinatum is very important remedy for the tongue cancer, and it works. I have worked with Kali sinatum with very good results with cancer of a tongue. So this is what one has to understand while understanding the remedies. So this close relationship which he has mentioned in detail, which is lacking in your regular textbook, where Sisler have given a lot of, or he has done a lot of work and explained in detail. And now we'll learn only this biocombination in today's session. Biocombination 17 is a piles, hemorrhoids, it has been mentioned. But generally, if you consider the contents of it, then you will think with my logic. Yes, calcarea pleura in 3x potency, it is there. Degenerative pathology and vascular affections that we learn. Ferumfos, the first stage of inflammation. The Kalimur, the second stage of inflammation. And Kalifos is homeopathic tranquilizer. So instead of a piles, you can think of in number of elements. So degenerative inflammatory frustrating conditions. For example, a patient comes to you with cervical spondylosis, lumbar spondylosis. You can think of this remedy if he is having associated with varicose veins or associated with hemorrhoids. So instead of 26, you can think of a 17. So you have to use your logic at that time. So whenever patient complains, doctor, mala mulvadas apan tras hoto tyacha, then shift. Then instead of 26, go with the 17, because that covers both the aspects. That covers the degenerative pathology at both levels, along with the hemorrhoids or along with the inflamed veins. So in selecting these remedies, you have to utilize your logic very clearly. There is one more combination which contains the calcarea fluor. I told you regarding that earlier. It is number 23, which also contains the calcarea fluor, and it is written for toothache. But there are calcarea fluor with the ferumfos and with macfos. That's all. These are three remedies which are present. So whenever there is degenerative changes along with a pain is there, that remedy is very important. But there is caliphos is missing in that. Caliphos is present in 17 as well as 26. So it depends what type of patient comes to you, in what stage it comes to you, and accordingly this combination you can think. So I'm using with this logic, and when you use with this logic, it works beautifully. So degenerative inflammatory frustrating condition along with the hemorrhoids, along with the varicose veins, 17 number plays a very vital role. So I think we'll stop over here, because caliphos is a big issue. We have to learn caliphos in detail, and that's why instead of taking caliphos today, we'll learn it in tomorrow's session, so that everyone get it in detail and understanding of caliphos, because that remedy I used to use very commonly. In fact, it plays very vital role. Sometimes allopathic logic helps. What do they do? Have you seen the allopathic practitioners? How do they prescribe for any ailment, for even hypertension? How do they prescribe? They give one antihypertensive along with, at the end, there is one tranquilizer. For even if you go with the skin ailments to the skin specialist, they write all drugs at the end, they write the Atrax as a tranquilizer. Because that irritation is settled, and number of futures get settled very easily. That is the concept they use. Caliphos is the remedy for such use. I used to use with this application. So instead of learning caliphos today, we'll go ahead with caliphos in tomorrow's session at the same time, and we'll learn different applications of a caliphos puricum. So in the way I used to think regarding the caliphos, I will going to highlight in that lecture. There were a few things which are asked. There was one doctor who have asked that, sir, please teach mother tincture, role of mother tinctures. Yes, definitely we'll discuss the, if it depends upon how much time we get. But first, prior to it, I think we'll learn with biochemic, because this series is very fruitful and important for every practitioner. So we'll complete that, and then we'll go towards the mother tinctures also, because those are also one of the important things in your day-to-day practice. So thank you for attending the session and sharing the knowledge. We'll learn in this way till the lockdown period is there. And thanks for everyone who have attended the sessions, and ask your students and ask your friends to go through it, so that they become familiar with this biochemic system of medicine. And now you are quite sure that it is not just a superficial, but it is very, very deep knowledge the Sushilar was having. So thank you very much for attending. I ask Vinod to conclude the session, and tomorrow we'll continue at 2:30 with the caliphos puricum. Thanks a lot.